Hello everybody, welcome to a new legacy video. Today it's my birthday and how to celebrate it better than with a good old mono black reanimator. I mean, I'm joking of course, because you know there's a better ways to celebrate your birthday, but I certainly like a good old mono black reanimator action. We played 19 lands, 2 Lake of the Death, a card that's pretty rare in real life. It's from Alliances, I believe, and you can when it comes to play, you sacrifice a swamp, and that's normally black mana, but if you sacrifice another swamp, that's 4, so with 3 swamps, you can cast Grave Tithe, War Call Engine, or Massacre Roar. We also have Grizzlebrand and Iona, since we do have Animate Dead, couple of Exhum, and Reanimate, to reanimate our stuff, but this deck is much fairer than other versions of Reanimator. We have Dark Ritual, we have Thoughtseize, we have Turak with Brutality, and we can easily outcast these. In the sideboard we got some Surgical. You know what? I'm just thinking about it now. I want Pakrat in my sideboard. I don't know how many, but I want Pakrat. What do we cut for Pakrat? I'm gonna cut the Spyglass. I got this Ratchet Bomb, this Spyglass, and then let's just go with this. Whenever you play against sideboard hate, like Surgical, etc., you just sideboarding Pakrat, they board out Blinding Bolt, they board out, you know, stuff like that, and you just get them with the Pakrat. So, yeah, I think that could be a nice B plan, along with Leland the Last Hope, some Leyline, of course, more Discard Spell. I guess I can cut the rest for another Spyglass. Yeah, this is my final list. We do have 2 Surgical and 4 Leyline, but I think you really need a lot of graveyard hate, because Reanimator is a little bit... like, the Black Rare Reanimator is might be faster than you, and yeah, that's that. So we go to round number 1, but before that, I'll remind you that this video is offered you by ChannelFireball.com, so check that on their website, ChannelFireball.com, for every Magic the Gathering needs. Round number 1, we are on the draw. Despite this hand does not do much, we get double Thoughtseize, and that can be good enough to be keep. Alright, Seed of Synod. What do we draw? Nothing. We do have a Grave Titan in our deck, so I don't mind keeping a Dark Ritual until turn 4. Ooh, double Chalice. Now I really wish wow, my hand is just gone. Just don't have a hand anymore. Really wish I'd gone a Dark Ritual Thought Season 2, but how could I know that double Chalice? Alright, I'm gonna get rid of something that's gonna kill me at some point. So probably it's gonna be Thezzeret, Agent of Bolas. Yep. And now the Chalice will shut down my hand and most of my deck. Sure. So what are my outs now? All right. I'm gonna just wait. Let me just wait a little. My opponent can also just stumble on mana. They only had 2 Seeds of Synod. They might just draw more 4 drops or more Chalice. We can't just draw Grave Titan and Lake of Death and suddenly cast it. Alright, what did my opponent do with 2 mana? Oh, Thought Cast. Alright, that's a Grave Titan. That's the Grave Titan. So if we draw... Ooh. Ancient Tomb is gonna make my opponent able to cast Karn. They can also cast Chalice. And if that happens, my deck is left with not many castable spells. Just those 9. That's why I could have discarded Chalice and not the Tezzeret. Alright, Sai. Grave Titan will raise Psy at some point. Alright, I cast another Chalice on one, sure. Alright, do we draw Lake of Death? Come on, Lake of Death. Vroom Coil Engine. Alright, we are slowly getting there. 4 mana. 4 swamps. With 2 more, we can cast our 6 drops in a row, and that might be good enough. Unless my opponent... I mean, my opponent is doing some pretty fair stuff. Like, if they go... I guess if they go Karn minus, it's much stronger than going Tezzeret. They wouldn't even be able to cast Tezzeret. So yeah, I should have probably cast destroyed Karn, discarded Karn instead of Tezzeret. My fear was that they would have just cast a fast Tezzeret and kill me pretty fast. But now that I think about it, with all the artifact lands, Karn just does exactly the same. So I think I'm dead. I'm not dead next turn, but yeah, getting there, let's say. So next turn, I don't think my opponent will deal me 16. And then maybe I can stabilize with Vroomcoil Engine into Grave Titan. Had I killed, had I discarded Karn, my opponent doesn't seem to have black mana at the moment. Was that Walking Ballista? That deck, yes, Ballista for 4, so it's 10, 12, 16. That's unfortunate. Alright, we concede. We would have drawn the swamp. Yeah, maybe if I discard Karn there, I somewhat might win this game. Alright. I want to have this 6. Gonna cut for sure Iona. I got 1 Grazebrand. I got Brutalities. They don't seem to have that many spells. And yeah, I'm gonna keep Una's Prowler. It's not great, but I mean, I still have, I can still reanimate all my stuff, so yeah. Alright, let's go with this. Game number 2, let's see if we got a good one. Alright, this should do it. We got a turn 1 Ritual Entomb Exhume. I'm gonna go for it, I don't want to go slower. I don't want to go like Thoughtseize or something like that. If my opponent has a Surgical Extraction, I'll just be sad about it. My opponent doesn't even know what we play. I mean, it's pretty obvious what we play, but... Please don't Surgical me. If they Surgical me, it's gonna be pretty bad. Alright, they don't. And this deck does not play any Pale or Unmask. So I'm just gonna pass the turn. There's no point for me to draw now. I mean, that would mean that I go to discard. Sure. I guess that's pretty good. Alright, they pass. To attack, then this turn I want to draw 7, make a land drop, then play land, play a couple of discard spells. It's gonna be Duress and Thoughtseize, and then I can go to discard of a Grave Titan. For sure they drew Force of Will right now. It's pretty unfortunate. I'm gonna Thoughtseize and take whatever, I don't really know here. I'm gonna get a walking ballista. It's not that hard to lose once you reanimate the Grace of Burn on turn one, and that's how this deck are designed to go. Of course, like, you have to be quite lucky to open a Yark Reach on Tomb Exhum, but that happens. I don't want to show my opponent anything else, so I'm just going to play Swamp, reanimate the Grave Titan, and then I kill them the next turn. Because if I'm going to draw a, let's say, 7, then I have to discard, and I can show my opponent that I know my B plan, or I don't know. I just want them to not, like, now they're gonna probably cyber like Black Rat Reanimator or something like that. Whereas we can fight through a ley line with this deck. Yes, we do have a lot of reanimation, but we can also reanimate their creature if they have some. Maybe I was supposed to cyber some Exhum out, but it's not that they have much to board in. So I think this is okay, let's go. Alright, game number 3. Oh, Zend is not exceptional, but we can turn to Grave Titan with 2 Dark Ritual. I'm gonna keep, of course, I'm on 6. And we got a Thoughtseize. Put this on 5, meanwhile. But that happens a lot. Whenever you play like a very fast combo deck, your opponent just digs for Cyber Hate and just die. Like, do you remember when we played Mana Dredge? A couple of our opponents just mulliganed and died. So it's real for sure. I'm gonna top this. I think it's better than drawing a. I mean, I can Thoughtseize away a creature of there and then reanimate the turn after. I'm gonna get to 4 and scry to the top. Alright, I'm gonna Thoughtseize them. Hopefully they have a creature. No. But they have the Tigris of War. Did I record with that deck? I think I did, right? Like a Tesserator. Tesserator-esque. Alright, see what they left on top. If it's like a Demir Signet, that's a very good start. Wow. So despite their mulligan to 4, I have 0 cards in hand. Oh, speaking of good draws, that's a Grave Titan. So 3, 5, 6, Grave T. And then my opponent can draw like an Ensnaring Bridge. If they do that, do I lose to Ensnaring Bridge? I think I do. I should have maybe have a Ratchet Bomb to deal with that. Hopefully it'll never come up, since, you know, the classic, I'll change a card, and then you just totally lose to it. I mean, totally lose because the lack of it. So yeah, whenever you do this, I'll change a card. Make sure that the tournament isn't that big. Like, if it's a Magic Online League, sure, like, you learn a lesson. But don't just go to, I don't know, whatever event you think it's big for you, and just, you know, change a card the day before. So we got Grease of Brand. It's gonna be a while since I cast that, so let's just attack for 10 and put my opponent dead next turn. My opponent Mulligan to 4 really shaped out well, by the way. If I hadn't drawn a Grave Titan there, it would have been pretty hard to win. I would have had like 2 Dark Ritual reanimated and uncastable with no Ratchet Bomb in my deck to deal with a Chalice. Alright, please opponent die. Don't play as Narrow Bridge. Do not play as an Iron Bridge. Yes. Alright, we are 1-0. We'll be back for round number 2. We got paired against the same guy. And that doesn't really happen that often. It only happens if my opponent was at his, her, is or her first, sorry, fifth league. And now joined the new league. So we basically see each other as new entities. Otherwise, they fixed it. And now you don't get paired against the same person, like, in 2 minutes. Keep this hand, it's fine against Chalice. Since we can go 2-2 on a Sprawler, turn 3 anime dead. Opponent with a turn 1 Ancient Doom Chalice, which is what their deck's supposed to do. You also got an Iona. Iona. So, 2 mana, Demurse Ignite, sure, do they have a land? Nope, alright. Una Sprawler get in there, as in the best of the cubes. 2 mana, it's a way for you to dump all your big dummies. That's one of the cube special. It's not insane in cube. You have to be like pretty hard on Reanimator, but as you see, it's a 2 mana effective ways for you to discard your creatures as well as, you know, attack, or if you have Recurring Nightmare. It's a body for that. Your opponent can discard it as well. Sometimes this can be annoying if they also are onto some graveyard shenanigans. Alright, they have 3 mana. What do they do with 3 mana? Psy, Master Chapterist? It is Psy. Okay, now we have to decide whether we want to reanimate Ionan in blue, which is probably what I want to do. Since that deck is basically mono blue, I mean, we saw 2 trees of pills. But I'm not expecting them to have, like, Nature's Claim. I don't know. Maybe they have like Assassin's Trophy. And that would be pretty bad. If the Assassin's Trophy might animate dead. But Iona still goes in the graveyard, right? So I can reanimate again. Not that I have a reanimation card, but. Alright, opponent's giving a little bit of think. A good little think here. I'm going to discard end phase. Actually, no. Attack first and then reanimate Iona. Doesn't matter. And then to discard my face. Come on, opponent! Play faster! This is one of the things I can't control on. Like, if you get paired against an opponent who's, like, you know, cooking or cleaning or thinking about casting explosives to make a token, no, yeah. They were probably just thinking about it. Alright, so they got a top turn now. I can't attack anymore, but it's not that big of a deal. Still going to reanimate my Iona named Blue. I could have reanimated Grave Titan, since my opponent can just throw in a bunch of topters, chomp and draw and stuff like that with their Force of Will. Alright, I guess now I have nothing to do. Their hand was very good against me. They had a Throne Chalice, a Force of Will, and a Psy. So they can now sacrifice the explosives, draw a card, be able to make your their land drop, and you know, go on from there. We don't have that many top deck now at our disposal. We have Exhumes, Anime Dead, Lake of the Death. Lake of the Death will get us to play a Grave Titan. Even with a spare mana, I believe. Basically, you can cast Grave Titan with 2 swamps. You can cast it on turn 3 with 2 swamps. Alright, so Walking Ballista. What else? They'll probably just kill my Una Sprawler. But I don't think I want to discard anything. Maybe I do, though. The thing is that I can't just draw lands and be able to cast all my stuff, because they don't seem to kill me very soon. So that's the thing, you know? But if I draw a land and reanimate Iona, it should probably be good enough. Like, it's not great, because... probably should just discard Wurmcoil, but then what if I draw lands to cast Wurmcoil and I don't have it in my graveyard? So yeah, the thing is, I'm very underdog now to win the game. Opponent has a lot of stuff going on, and we just don't have anything, but a draw step can just totally turn this all around. Like a Lake of the Death, or an Exhum, or an Animate Dead. It's basically just that. It's pretty crazy how both of the game one we lost the Chalice, and then game 2 and 3 opponent. I mean, game 2 last game we had pretty strong draws. Sure, take 5. I don't really want to block with Magnus Prowler. Actually, I might just block. That will soak up some damage. If I want to discard 2 cards, 2 Magnus Prowler, that's fine. Because the thing is that, you know, I might be able to survive a couple of turns. Or do they want to sacrifice something or cast card? Oh, Thezzeret. Why didn't they main phase it? Alright, I want to go up, sure. Iona now could be too late now. I guess just Iona could be too late. Oh, Lake of the Death. Alright. So we got there. So we're gonna play Lake of the Death. Sacrifice a swamp. Top Lake of the Death. Sacrifice a swamp. And then what do I cast? Grave Titan or Wurmcoil? The problem is that they have Baleful Strix for my Grave Titan. And next turn I can't cast another 6 drop right away. The thing with Grave Titan is that it's gonna create 4 zombies in the meanwhile, so I think it's pretty good. Wurmcoil, though, on the other hand, gains me 6. But I don't think I'm in a mana problem. I have, sorry, in life points problems. I have enough life points. Now I wish I did not block. I guess my opponent could have just Walking Ballista killed the Prowler. So it would have been the same result, except that they would have dealt me 1 more. So I think I'm fine with my blocks. All right, Lake of the Death, very good draw. One of the few that could have, you know, still make me able to, you know, play this game. Our opponent draws Trees of Tales, plays Baleful Strix. Also, there's this Tezzeret threatening the... Yeah, I should have definitely played Grave Titan. The problem is that my opponent's gonna kill me next turn. They have so many artifacts. 3, 6, 9, yeah. They have 11 artifacts. It's gonna be 22 damage. Oh, Thresher was -4? I thought it was -5. Alright, then we play great and I got destroyed. Okay, still don't have the Ratchet Bomb. So I'm gonna do the same thing. Not sure I want to kill Iona. Yeah, I guess I will. Grizzly Brand is just better. I think I'm fine in cutting these for these. Like, we still have Entomb, so it's not that you have to draw this. You only have Luna Sprawler to discard from your hand now that we cut Brutality. So I think it's fine to cut these. You don't want to draw those. Let's go. I mean, you also have Thoughtseize on yourself, but you don't really want to do it. On the play... Alright, I got a turn 3 massacre worm with some spyglass to... Ooh, they have a ley line. Okay, so no turn 3 massacre worm. Probably turn 6 massacre worm. And, our turn 3 massacre worm. I'm gonna go for a spyglass here. I don't really go turn 3 massacre worm. I guess I can, in case, I see my opponent does nothing because they kept on the ley line, there's like 5 lands and etc. Ooh, they have a snare bridge in their hand. I'm gonna name Karn, I think. Yeah, their hand does nothing. Unfortunately, they have, I mean, that's nothing that I can name. It's not that there's nothing that they force. Oof, the draw land, they chalice me, and yeah, this game is over. I died to like any land for a snare and bridge since I have no way to deal with that. I guess I can with. Yeah, I can't. No, I can't. I can't even cast a discard spell. Well, this would have been a great draw if they didn't have. If they didn't draw land. I would have been able to Thoughtseize now their Force of Will and then cast Massacre Worm and then probably win with it. I guess they also had the Snare Bridge to be afraid of. Opponent is so slow, I'm just gonna concede. I don't wanna play this game anymore. Be back for round number 3. Let's go. We are on the draw with a mulligan. Sure. Do we want this Thoughtseize or we don't? Gotta keep it. If you play against combo, you want a Thoughtseize. If you do not play against combo, then it doesn't really matter. We just have a turn to a reanimation kill. Scouting Tarndo makes me pretty scared. Maybe we want to just go Thoughtseize now, since this entomb, it's all we want to resolve. If we resolve this entomb, then my opponent can't even draw counter. We have 3 animate dead. So all in all, I would have loved to draw Thoughtseize against any like blue deck or combo deck. Spicy Chicken is their name. Not a fan of spicy food. It's it's very common in the States. A bit of Mexican food. The thing is that in Italy we have a. We really don't have that much non-Italian food. Like, yeah, sure, you can eat whatever you want. You can eat sushi, you can eat... actually, not even Mexican food. Like, where I live, there's not any Mexican place or stuff like that. But, so basically, the spicy food to me are more like Asian food or Mexican food. So yeah. All this for saying that... that I'm not a fan of spicy food, just because, you know, I'm not grown in an environment where spicy food was very common. So whenever I go to the States, I always ask for non-spicy, and whenever I get spicy food, I'm like, I don't really like it, but, you know, it's not that I don't love it. I'd rather just not have it, because at the end, you just are just there. Like, at the end of a meal, you want to, you know, enjoy, you know, feel the taste, and like, this was a good meal, you know. Whereas with spicy food, you're just there and like, oh, my mouth burn, you know, and you don't have a positive memory. That's for me. In the meanwhile, our opponent is countering everything, Thoughtseize, and now going to play Gurma Gangler, and we can just have nothing left. But we can draw a tomb. Nope. Opponent very good realizing that Entomb is the card to counter. Rixis Delver. It's one of a bad pretty bad matchup for this deck, but we could be able to pull this off if we draw an Entomb. P- Honduras. Big fish. Bitter blossom, so I think. And entomb. Ooh, Lake of the Death. Alright. Still nothing, because we got our two animate dead with no creature to reanimate. Alright. Priority in cleaning the pond, the brainstorm. Okay, do we draw? I guess Broncoil Engine is still a good draw. Because I can reanimate it if I'm playing Force of Wills it. Dark Ritual is not, so we concede. Alright, definitely gonna go for the Pack Rats. And I think Liana last up too. I'm going to discard what? Again, the reanimation package. I think it's fine to discard, to sideboard out. Reanimate and animate dead are still fine with Pack Rat and just paired with discard spell. I think I like the rest. What if I just cut Dark Ritual? I wanna go maybe a little bit slower. So I think this is okay. This is okay to me. On the play. At this end, remember, we are not that much of a combo deck. We are also like, you know, this end is just a discard end. We have a lot of ways to discard cards. And now from this end, I can also get rid of just the True Name Nemesis, so that I can reanimate it whenever I want. They're free to just, you know, Thoughtseize, Spell, Pure Search, call my hand. Next turn, I'm going to probably discard Surgical. Like, the thing with Spell Pierce is that they can assemble pretty large amount of lands. And, oh, they got rid of Brutality, not Duress. Oh, the Surgical and Brutality. Sure. It's like if I Brutality their Surgical for free. But I also get to see my deck, which is pretty bad, because I can now know that I have Pack Rat in the deck. And bring back Bolt, maybe. Alright, we're gonna go Brainstorm here. Brainstorm was a good draw. Alright, of course not playing Liliana Hope right now. Because they have Spell Pierce up. I'm just to prolong this game, as often happens when you just exchange discard, you just exchange like five discard spell, four discard spell. Alright, that's a Pack Rat, I'm gonna play it. I don't expect my opponent to have Lightning Bolt, so I don't mind if I don't have 3 mana up to discard. Yeah, they force. Pitch dates, okay. Now if I draw a land, I can slam this Liliana Hope. Dark Ritual will let me play Grave Titan. Yes, they can have a daze. Alright, Spell Pierce there. I'm happy with that. It's kind of a 2-for-1. I mean, it's not a 2-for-1 because Dark Ritual also 2-for-1s. I guess they double Spell Pierce, so yeah, it is a 2-for-1. Mismatching Spell Pierce. Nice. Alright, they drew a lot of situational counters, and that I think heard them quite a lot. Alright, I can go Liliana up now and plus her. And then I can go minus, get back the pack rat. I think this game, we behaving like mono black control was very good. I'd really want to animate that their Trunum Nemesis. I'd rather just keep the animate in hand, For when I discard Grave Titan to the pack rat and then animate that back. But yeah, this is also fine. I think opponent has 6, so I'm going to animate that back the pack rat. Get dazed. As they immediately have 3 after they have 6. Alright, Wasteland's yours. We got an Entomb right after we get the head out. Alright, sure. I'm going to just plus and attack for 1. Not in a hurry of discarding. Trunum Nemesis. Sure. Going to discard Grave Titan. Alright, going to plus Liliana. I can also minus and double pack rat. How does that sound? I think it sounds crazy to me. This way I can attack. Other way I couldn't have attacked because my opponent would have had a 3-1. Now I have 2-4-4s, so they go to 8. Packard is just an egregious cyber plan, I think, for a deck like this. Very happy I thought about it last second before submitting the list. Too bad that I cut the Ratchet Bomb for it, but, you know, can be perfect. One cannot be perfect. I think I like their creature just because it's very efficient against Spell Pierce and Daze. You can just play a spell, they go Spell Pierce, you go Dark Creature in response. Maybe I just don't like Entomb. Like, it sounds crazy, but the fact that they have so many counters and surgical, I think the reanimation plan is really off. Like, you just use your animate dead and reanimate to reanimate back the pack rat that they kill. Somehow, they're gonna have Lightning Bolt in this game. But I think it's okay. I think I like this plan better. Let's go. Alright, we got the pack rat. We got the Abs Durak 2 we play. Wow, I've never drawn it thus far. Not even considering Cyberding out any time. It's just a card that I've... It's like we play 56 cards. Or more 2-drop. It's not ideal, but I take it. I'm probably gonna go turn 1 into Umba, just hoping for it to get like Daze or Pierced or whatever. Velocity Stormed maybe. Oh, they got Delver of Secrets. Turn 2. That's signalizing to me a counter magic, which I really hope they go on here. No. Just let it resolve immediately. Primeg Reservoir in the bin. I'm not gonna go, I think, Dark Ritual. I have to counter this. Too scary to not counter this. Maybe I was supposed to go Amdurak first, but or Brutality first, but I wanted to just go a dark reach onto Turek Brutality. That was the plan. Pretty sure they have Surgical in hand. If they didn't counter that that Entombed, they must have Surgical in hand. Not that I care. Like, I really don't care about Surgical, but just saying. Alright, I'm gonna go for him to Turek here. He's got Gurmag and Wasteland. Okay, they have 6th, so my Brutality now will be free. I'm pretty sad that I played my Entomb now. It means that I don't have a card in there to discard to Brutality. Okay, did my opponent draw land? Yeah. They did draw land. So now I'm going to... just -2/-2, I believe. You're gonna just -2/-2 twice. I don't think they have a... I don't think they have a counter. Because they would have countered Amtaturak and they... sorry, I don't think they have a spell because they would have used it on Amtaturak. Sure, I think I'm gonna do like this. They might have Lightning Bolt. Yeah, that's exactly what I thought. I thought that the only spell in hand that they can have is Lightning Bolt, so I don't want to go discard a card to duress you. And I don't want to play Pakrat because you can have Lightning Bolt. And it worked out great. No, they drew Spell Pierce. Because they didn't have it last turn, but they would have flipped the Elver with. But it's okay, I'm still in a great shape. If I draw land, I can start Pakratting. I can also just play 2 Pakrats, actually. I don't care about the land. Who have to Turek? I'm gonna play that first. They have a land for sure. 2 lands, okay. All the 2-for-1s in this game. And now Pakrat against an elemental. We're on 10 life. But we will start discarding Pakrats. Get rid of Duress. I think it's better than Pakrat because I'm gonna block this elemental, and if my opponent has a removal spell on the other Pakrat, we trade. But I think I have to block. Maybe I shouldn't though. Maybe I shouldn't. Yeah, this attack is suspicious to me, so I'm gonna take. Maybe I shouldn't attack in the first place. It's weird. They have M14, the Empire Master, and the Eternal Master token. Usually, Magic Online puts you the same token into play, but alright, opponent is thinking about it. I'm gonna take 1 damage if my opponent attacks. I can't risk them having like a counter on my Pakrat. Like, actually, there isn't a counter on my Pakrat, so I don't know. Whatever. I'm gonna definitely discard this swamp, so I'm happy with the attack now. Put the blocks and just let it go. Don't make a token. Alright, what's that? They body kicked. Alright. Let's discard this and sacrifice the new rat. So by the way we played. We got in for damage. Alright. Cabal therapy. That's fine. I can also just draw a reanimation card and get Grace of Brand into play. I didn't think about it. I have that Grace of Brand into play into my graveyard. My opponent, without it. Ooh. They got rid of my Pakrat. That's fine. Hopefully, they don't kill both of my Pakrats now. Or even if they play. Wow, they named Grave Titan first. It was just the top of my deck. Probably are just riding away. Both the games after sideboard. Yes, we did. Great. Alright, we're 2-1. We'll be for round number 4. But before that, I'll remind you that ChannelFireball.com is the website that not only sells cards, but also buys your cards. So go to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to check their price on your cards and add to that a 30% store credit bonus if you want to trade with them. On the play for the 4th round, what do we got? Disneyland is not very good. Had we had another land, this would have been fine, but as things stand, it's a pretty bad one, I think. Alright, I'm gonna keep... I think I'll bottom these. Alright, now I wish I had kept it. I guess I'll take Emrakul. Had I had a Brutality on top, I would have discarded Show and Tell. But the reason why I got rid of Brutality is that this hand was good with a Grave Tyrant-ish cards, or like an Entomb. Certainly not another reanimate. Opponent did bottom top. No, I would love to draw him to draw. I mean, Razor Brand. Entomb is always the perfect draw, but I wouldn't mind that too. Not shuffle with a ponder. And Iona. Yep, and I kept that Brutality. Would have been good though. Would have taken a couple of more turns because I wouldn't have Iona yet in hand, so I would have discarded already with Brutality. I have a plan though. My plan is my opponent plays Show until I play Iona. Definitely Omniscience. And then they want to go cantrips, I guess. Bottom top, mountain, pass. Something. I think I have 0% win rate game once. Thus far. As I'm gonna lose this game as well. My opponent may be looking for, maybe it's pulling off the BBD special and never finding a creature to react to put into play with Show and Tell. Alright. I guess I'll thought it myself now. Yeah. So I'll play Lake of Death. Sacrifice the Swamp. Thought it myself. If this resolves, then I have infinite counters. Sorry, infinite reanimation cards. I don't care about life, so I'm gonna just start casting those reanimates. And then I can lose to Sneak and Show, of course. But my opponent will have to find exactly Sneak and Show. I'm gonna tap Lake of the Death. 4/4. Because I want to play around Spellpierce. But the deck does play Spellpierce. So I'll start with a reanimate, as I said. So if my opponent goes Sneak and Show, Grizzly Burn, or Emrakul, it doesn't matter how much it's my life total. I should probably just start with Animate Dead, actually. Alright. They force Pitch Show and Tell. I know there's two cards. So I can go Animate Dead now. Wow, that was an unexpected win. All right, happy that happened though. I think I'm fine with Surgical. Usually I don't like Surgical, but this deck plays so many Discard Spell that it's very likely that we just go Discard Spell, Exile, all your stuff. All your, like, Show and Tell or whatever you have in hand. I'm gonna cut these two creatures. And, I don't really see much else. I mean, I can't go Pockrat. But I don't expect my opponent to have particular sideboard hates. Also, we do want to care about them first and then reanimate. So I think this sideboarding this light is fine. Let's go with this. Alright, game number two. Unfortunately, we have a Yonain end. I think I'm gonna keep this end. We have Amtuterup, which is very strong. And if I draw any to discard, or if we resolve this Turok, I don't know. Opponent for sure with many counter magic up. Where can it go? I'm gonna go into them. If they counter this, maybe there's a higher chance that the Turok resolves. Next turn, I can Grave Titan them. So there's that. I could also Surgical the Spell Pierce first. Because it's not unlikely that they follow a second one. But we can also just get rid of their Show and Tell forever. This was pretty lucky, I have to say. They got four Speech Omniscience. Wow, they have one card left. And they're gonna slam. I don't know, why didn't they four Speech? Whatever. Lake of Death. Sacrifice this. A4. Sacrifice this. Gravy Tea. Turn 3, Grave Titan after a flurry of discard spell. That's exactly what you want to do with this deck. Especially in this matchup. Ponder, not Shuffle. And wow, Show and Tell. No, there's a Grisabrand there. Alright, but they're 7-7. I guess in the end we got lucky to open Ione in my hand. Alright, what's the plan now? There's an Ione name in blue, so I'm not sure why there. Oh, Cage. Okay. Cage is annoying. I'm gonna tap with Grave Titan, I guess. And the tokens. Probably have to turn it first. For no real reason, actually, but why not? I don't want to attack with Iona because they can just block and then, you know, do their stuff. Whereas now, actually, the zombies attack are pretty stupid. I'm gonna just attack with a Grave Titan. Okay. They die my opponents back to 11, but they're dead on this attack, so they have to go sneak attack now, or they concede. Alright, this was relatively easy. We're 3 and 1, we're back for the last round. Final round of today, we are on the play. Wow, alright. You always, it takes also always a little bit to realize how good your hand is, or how bad your hand is. This case is very good. Opponents on 6. They scry to the top. We don't care. We play Dark Ritual. We play Entomb. We play Animate Dead. And we play Grizzlebrand. 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 Alright. Let's just do. I just wanted to show that there's Dark Ritual, but apparently I can't, so. Oops. Alright. You know I like to do the screenshot for the Twitter, so, you know. You have to watch me doing this. Okay, so in the dark, the Pack Rats will come in. And we cut some. Not Grave Titan. some reanimation cards like Exhumes, Una Sprawler, and an Entomb. Yep, let's go. Alright, we got a Fine Hand Island. Go. More discard spell. I think once again I just wanna. Actually, I don't know. Ooh, end of turn brainstorm. We might play against another combo deck here. Yes, we do. And as a show and tell. Alright, these are some fast magic. Some fast magic over here. So I'm gonna cut the Pankrats. Going to put back configuration as it was. Some surgicals for these two. Let's go. We got some discard spells. So yeah, this end is very cool. I'm gonna go discard spell, discard spell, discard spell. Hopefully drawing a Grisebrand Aurora in Iona so I can escalate the brutality. Discard to the bottom. Oh, that's a pretty bad hand. I mean, they can, they're just Oh, I realized that if I had Thoughtseize, I could have discarded Surgical, Grisebrand. I guess I still have Surgical. Alright, so they drew Petal. Gonna go home to Turak here. Alright, so let's hope to get Econ Truth and Grisebrand out. What? I didn't. Oh my god. That's so unlucky. I didn't discard Grisebrand. Alright. Ooh, but there's an Entomb. Okay, I'm gonna put into my graveyard, I think Iona. Actually, probably Grisebrand's better. No, I'm gonna just go Iona. And then I'll exhume it back. Naming blue. Pass. I'm gonna go Iona so that the opponent can't go land show and if I go Grisebrand, my opponent can go land show and tell Grisebrand. Whereas now, it's gonna be a long path before they find the sneak attack. Not even sure if they have sneak attack. Going to brutality them. Well, actually I won't. If I draw a creature, I can just escalate, discard a creature and then reanimate it. Brutality can't even discard the sneak and show, so basically there's nothing that I care about for my opponent's hand. But might as well, right? Yeah, maybe I could have no, actually, they never drew the third land. So this should be the game right now, right here. GG. Ooh, 4-1. And we, the only loss was to a deck that's not very much played. This deck performed very well. I'm really excited for it. Yeah, I mean, I would change it like this, probably. Just a couple of Ratchet Bomb over... That's a Spyglass. Pankrats, great. All right, thanks for watching, guys. We'll be back next time with more Legacy, more video. And yeah, if you like this video, please press like on the YouTube page. Subscribe to the ChannelFireball channel and we'll see you next time. Goodbye.